Hey guys, Prestige here, bringing up episode number 22 of The Road to Gold. This time we are using the MK46 light machine gun, which reminds me, if you happen to miss any of the other 21 episodes of Road to Gold, you can check them out in the Road to Gold official playlist on the right side of the screen in the related video somewhere over there. It is so official, it's unbelievable. So anyways, this weapon is amazing when it comes to playing game types like Domination, Ground War, Team Deathmatch, and Sabotage. Yes, Sabotage. I put Sabotage in there because this has the perfect amount of bullets to lay down suppressive fire for your team to keep the enemies away from the bomb while your team plants the objective. It's really awesome, actually. I was trying to get a Sabotage gameplay for you guys earlier, but I decided to go with TDM. It's really the only thing I like to do for videos. TDM, Kill Confirm, Domination. If there's a game type that you guys would like to see, please leave me a comment down below because you guys are probably getting tired of Team Deathmatch. But anyways, some things that I can suggest using with this MK46. I almost forgot the name of the weapon for a second. The MK46, since it is a light machine gun, I highly suggest using a explosive or a launcher, some sort of launcher for your secondary weapon. Make yourself an explosive gunner. You can have the perfect combination of explosive damage and suppressive fire to help your team out on those objectives or just taking out air support for your team. Make sure that you are a team player with this class. That's all I can suggest. As for attachments for it, you don't really need the kick proficiency. I suggest going with the attachments proficiency using the grip, but also using any other attachment. For this episode, I'm going with the holographic sight. It's one of the only weapons I can tolerate with this holographic sight. Not sure why, I just enjoy using it, and I highly suggest having you guys check it out too. But why? Well, I'm suggesting a lot of things. I think I'm going to be like a Nobel Prize winner one day. But anyways, I wanted to talk a little bit about Black Ops 2 and what I suggest Treyarch to put in for camouflages. I know that Modern Warfare is, you know, they got their gold camouflage for doing this and that, but I think Treyarch was going in the right direction with having your emblem creator, like the create an emblem. I think that they should do create a camouflage. And I mean, if you have watched PC gameplay of Call of Duty 4 or World at War, you notice that a lot of the PC gamers can mod their camouflages on their weapons, and that actually comes out to see, it actually comes out to be some pretty cool stuff. And I mean, we've seen it with games like Midnight Club, where you can make, or actually Forza better, where you can actually import photos and stuff and make your own custom sort of decals on your cars. I think that they should do that for weapons. That would be amazing. The only thing that I can see that would kind of hurt that would be like branding, like Monster Energy or stupid little things like that that would kind of negate the way to do it. But I think that they were going in the right direction with the emblem editor. They should do that with camouflage. You can imagine having, and this is just for example, if you use the MK46 with Red Tiger, you'll notice that on the front of the weapon, the barrel is actually blue, and then the rest of the weapon is red. I noticed that the other day, and I just think that that would be awesome to combine colors like that. Make like a rainbow camouflage, or, you know, bright orange tiger with like green tiger in there. That, I mean, just thinking of all the different camouflage combinations, and then on top of that, putting them inside the community so others can download your creation and rate it. That would be perfect, just like how Black Ops did with rating clips and watching clips. That was perfect. It was a great introduction, and not many people know, but Call of Duty Elite was supposed to go with Black Ops. That's why there was so much stuff in there. It happened to come out with Modern Warfare 3, and I think that it can only improve from here. But guys, that is basically my thoughts on what should be coming to Black Ops 2. I think that they should do custom camouflages. I don't know how you all feel about that, but if you have your own comments, leave them down below. I'll make sure to check them out. If I think that they're worthy enough to get a response, maybe I'll leave my own comment back to you. But guys, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please drop a like. If not, that's cool. And remember, I'm on my road to 10,000 subscribers. We are about 200 off from 9,000. If you want to join, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Bye!